That's such a load to carry. I had to drive this time. Usually I like to get my exercise walking in neighborhoods. So, Charlene, how is it going with your new Avon business? You're kidding me. You have 27 customers in 1 week. Well, I think you were born to do this. And if I do say so myself, I think I knew that. Well, congratulations to you. I am so proud. So happy for you. Well, I have some exciting things with me. As you know, I have your beauty showcase. Your own. And I brought a couple of other goodies as well. So, and I see it's the season already. I usually don't put mine out until November 1st, but why not? It's October. It's colder. Perfect for a cup of hot chocolate and some walnuts by the fire, right? What I want to know is, does your husband crack these for you? This sure makes things a lot easier, doesn't it? Do you mind if I put these over to the side? Your order forms. You still have another week on this campaign, so you can continue to take orders. And then at the end of the week, you'll fill out this order form and send it in to Avon. And within usually less than a week, you will receive your first order. Okay, so let's see here. Show you this. This is one of our new compacts. ordered it for myself, so isn't that lovely? Love the deep blue and green sort of jewel tones. It's perfect for winter time, don't you think? And it's kind of puffed up like a quilt. Very elegant. And I love the oval shape. It's a little bit more petite than the one I used to carry. And as you can see, I have a lot of things in my pocketbook. So, I just get messier and messier the older I get. So, let's see. I'll take this out in case I have a note. And oh, one other thing I wanted to show you. So, my aunt sent me this for my birthday a couple months ago, and she knows that I'm an Avon representative, and you know, I used to use this change purse to kind of keep my Avon things separate from my household budget, but it's kind of small, and two wallets, it's just not practical. So I must have been complaining about that to her, because she got me this wonderful, beautiful billfold, and it's not just any billfold. Of course, it has your usual features, but I use this side right here to keep my information and pictures and so forth. And I also slide some stamps right down inside there. They fit perfectly. Anyway. And I just slide my driver's license, social security, Stearns card, of course. Just slides right down in there neatly. And folds up nicely. And then I keep my my household budget right here. At least the dollar bills. And close that up. And then you'll see this has a double French clasp. So if you open it, see? Two change purses. And the one sort of on the inside, I use just for my change for, again, my household budget. And, just kind of makes sense to me, at least in my head, to keep the change closest to the rest of the billfold, where my household budget is for dollar bills. And then in a separate change purse, I've got other bills and other change. And this is how I keep everything separate for Avon. So the change purse on the outside, I think of that as, you know, inside is my home and outside is my business. And, oh my goodness, this is so easy. I can make change. And even if, let's say I run out of $1 bills, I could make change myself. I could pull out a $5 from Avon's side and open up household side and grab $5 $1 bills if I have them and make change. So I sort of become my own bank. But it's important really not to do that unless you actually can make change. You don't want to be borrowing from your household account. It's got to be an even trade. But anyway, I find that it works just fine to fold my bills just like that and tuck them in, kind of move the change to one side. And again, if I accumulate too many pennies, for example, then I can make change and maybe take a dime from this side and put it in here, take 10 pennies out and put it in our change dish. So, anyway, I just wanted to show you that. Certainly wasn't my idea, it was my aunt's. It's brilliant. She's such a thoughtful person. Aunt Arthella. What a lady. Anyway, just thought I would show you that. And, the rate that you're going, I think you're going to have enough profit pretty quickly to buy something like this for yourself. Boxes are empty. All right, so I did open the box and take a peek. Things in there so I could carry it. Okay. So let me present to you. Your very own beauty showcase. Squeeze in that ball. Like I said, I popped a few things in here. Let me take them out. We'll go on a grand tour of your very own beauty showcase. About your new Avon Beauty Showcase. This showcase has been carefully inspected to eliminate all flaws of material or workmanship. It is fully guaranteed for 1 full year from date received. Now here are some useful tips. Carry only the current demonstration products and 3 or 4 other products on special each campaign. Remember, customers want to see what's new. Of course, you'll want to carry your demonstrators, fragrances, makeup, lipstick, and a few samples, but don't overload your showcase for these reasons. 1, it makes removal of products for customer demonstrations difficult. 2, it makes the showcase unduly heavy for carrying in your territory. And 3, it may cause strain on the showcase parts. And the guarantee. This Avon Beauty Showcase is guaranteed for 1 full year from date received to be free of defects. Should the showcase fail due to material or workmanship, within 1 year it should be returned to your Avon branch with a note indicating the problem and asking either for a replacement showcase or a refund, whichever you desire. Showcase defects resulting from abuse or inappropriate use will not be covered by this guarantee. You enjoy your new Avon Beauty Showcase, and that it will provide many campaigns of useful service to you and the customers you serve. Pretty common sense advice, I think. So I'll leave this. So now it's time for the grand tour. Now I'm sure there are certain features that will not be a surprise since you've seen me with my beloved beauty showcase. But I want to point out that for easy storage, the handles do fold inside the center compartment. You just need to gently bend them. They're made out of a very flexible flexible vinyl and the attachments right here are hinged so you can see how easy it is to maneuver the handle. You can just hold the handle like a pocketbook, like that, or under your arm like that, if it's not too heavy. Usually I'll do that after I've made my deliveries, and I'll carry it like this when it's heavy. Now while we're here, notice that this central compartment is very wide, deep, spacious. And again, as you've seen me many times, I use this for my paper materials, my customer record book, my campaign brochures, things like that. Anything that's paper, calling cards and so forth. So that's very nice, and it's completely separate from the other two compartments. Okay, and then this side display side, and see because of the clear vinyl here, you can choose to stack your demonstrators, samples, any of the products that you bring along with you that are not orders. And see, they've packed it very nicely so it'll keep its shape. Of course, the holidays are coming up, so if you have any out-of-town family that you mail gifts to, this would be marvelous packing. See, always tell my customers that this is the fun side of the bag. Because they'll never know what surprises might be inside until you open the curtain. Display side. There we go. And then let's just swing it around. And this is the business side. There's no clear vinyl here. We just have the beautiful floral green, blue, and gold vinyl. Just want to bend that back a little bit so you can see. And this side. Orders in and just line up the bags depending on whether or not you have a customer who has ordered quite a few things. I find that I can usually get 6 or 7 bags lined up. And of course, I'm not delivering to my entire territory in one day or one afternoon. So I usually just pace it so that, you know, 6 or 7 will be receiving orders. Others, maybe a few others, will be receiving callbacks. Something like that. And then on the next day, load her up with 6 or 7 more orders and make your rounds. Keep in mind that we work on 2-week cycles. So I find that getting through all of my clients within a 2-week period works very well for the size of this case. There you go, my dear. Treat her well. So this off to the side, okay? Down inside your box. Okay. Right. So, let's pick up where we left off. We looked at your first step to success, get acquainted, last time. And now we'll look at your second step, a dependable Avon income. Second step that she has her beauty showcase with her. I know you're so excited about that. So, your Avon business is a business of people, customers. Your first step, get acquainted. Have you gotten acquainted with all the families in your territory? How many customers on your customer record? 30 customer orders equals about $45 in earnings. 60 customers, about $90 in earnings. And 100 customers, about $150 in earnings. Now, I understand that you have 27 new customers, which is simply phenomenal. You can expect probably about $40 for those orders. Of course, it depends on what people order. It may be less this time because you didn't have any demonstrators. You did have some perfume samples, but no demonstrators. And of course, when you bring some of the products that are on special, those sell really well. And you'll find that customers might order the thing that they really intended to order, as well as the item that's on special. Partly because as you build your clientele and as you build your relationship, they will know what works for them. And it may be an opportunity for them to sort of save up and wait until something goes on sale and then make the purchase. And they may make a purchase of one or two or three of those items that are on sale. How has your time schedule worked out for you? Yes, well, of course, this coming week, if you want to continue to call on any homes that you weren't able to get to in the first week, but also, you can go back to any of the homes where you left a calling card. So, people can't become customers until you call. So call on every house. Get acquainted. So, just a little overview there. Every call doesn't lead to a sale at first. But dependable customer service builds a dependable income for you. And dependable customer service means reorders. So notice our Avon representative has an order that she's getting ready to deliver. But we are going to talk about reorders. You don't want to make a delivery without attempting to make a reorder. Deliveries are about more than delivering the order. Well, I got ahead of myself here. What is the best time to take reorders? When you deliver. You're there in the customer's home. New products, new specials, new things to show and talk about. Your customer needs to buy for maybe all of her family. You save time, yours and hers. Your dependable Avon income depends on reorders. Again, these first few months may be up and down when it comes to your income, but over time you're going to see it level out because certain customers will reorder with a delivery and other customers will not. But then the next time that will flip, and so things even out over time. Especially as you establish all of your relationships within your territory. Let's make a delivery. Write a reorder. You see this? So let's look at some of the suggestions here. Check each product you ordered and tell her what it will do for her. That's a very important step. You want to make sure that the products in the bag match the products on the order form. Put demonstration products in view. I've got something brand new to show you. And you could put something out on the table, something brand new. Or it may not be brand new to Avon, but maybe new to her. Point out money saving specials in the brochure. So, if I may, let's see. example, two of our most popular products are, can you see? We have the Vitamoist and the Cream Supreme. So Vitamoist is yellow and the Cream Supreme is in the pink pot. And notice that the regular price is $3, but they are on special for $1.98. Okay, so one of the first things I do when I receive new campaign materials is go through the entire catalog and look for specials. Specials on lipstick. Specials on nail color. Specials on eyeshadows and other eye makeup products. Skincare. Fragrance in different forms. And notice we do have a lot of specials. Skin So Soft here is the regular price. Regular price for some of these bath products, the scented bath products. But here we have a few bath products that are on special. My point is, I want to take note of all the specials and I might use a notebook of some sort. I use this notebook to keep all of my customer notes. And I'll use the back to keep note of specials and the front to keep all of my notes for each client. Let's see here. Here we go. So here's an example of the notes for two different clients. And I'm able to record not only what she's ordered in the past, but also things that she tells me about herself. Maybe that she has dry skin or she has oily skin. Maybe that she likes bright colors or tends to wear softer colors, things like that. I'm able to look at the types of products. So I might have one customer who likes to invest in lots of different fragrance products. So she might have a dram of perfume, she might have a cologne spray, she might have a cream sachet, all in the same fragrance. So I can look in the newest catalog and see if there are any discounts on, for example, beauty dust. And if there are, then that could be something I bring up to her as a special. In your favorite fragrance, we have this beauty dust on special. So what you want to do is make your visits very customized so that you show that you have listened and that you understand the unique needs and desires of each client. You could suggest things. You know, of course, we have the children's and the teens line of products. So here we have Mickey Mouse. So it could be something like, your daughter might like this, or your husband. We have a men's line. Your husband might like this for his hands if he works in a job that requires him to wash his hands a lot, and they might get very dry and chapped. We have men's hand creams. They don't smell like the ladies, and that's important to point out. Ask for the order. May I order this for you? So you've got several different options. It could be something that you're bringing physically to show. It could be something you're showing her in the specials. It could be something that you have as a demonstrator. Ask for the order. You will never get an order if you don't ask for it. They may say, no, not this time. But you can note that in your notebook and pay attention. It may be, not this time because I just ordered and paid for something, but if she sounds interested, make a note of it. It's something you can bring up next time or in a few weeks. Tell her how much she owes you for a previous order and thank her when she pays you. Now, this is very important. If customer is not ready to pay, then you are not ready to deliver. Okay? So all you need to do at the end of your visit, after you've gone over everything, hold the bag and say, be $4.34, and if she reaches for her billfold or something, then you know how this will play out. But if she doesn't, if she says, well, I can't pay you until next time, then all you need to do is simply hold onto the bag, start to put it back in your beauty showcase. And as you do that, very kindly suggest a time that you might call again to make the delivery. So, simply say, well, that's no problem at all. Is there a better time that I could make this delivery? Tomorrow or next week? And see what she says. You only need to do that once for a particular customer, and then they will understand that you're not going to make a delivery without receiving payment. Okay. Remember what I said last week. Avon makes it easy for you to pay Avon. Because you collect all of the payments from your customers first. Then look on your invoice, see how much you owe Avon, and then deposit at least that much into your checking account from the cash that you've collected. The remaining cash is yours, or you can certainly put it in the checking account if you like. So, this way of doing business ensures that you are never out of pocket for something that someone orders. You do not put the money up front to Avon. But I can promise you, if you get in the habit of delivering items without accepting payment at the same time, it will get out of hand. And so our last part, how does your customer feel about reorders? Again, this is where you are going to learn a lot about each one of your customers, and it's important to note that down. You are getting to know all of your customers in a very short period of time. I know my customers very well at this point. And if I take on a new customer, that's only one new customer out of all of my customers. So for you, it's going to be really important to keep good notes on what they tell you about themselves, what their interests are, and what their values are. They might really value some of our family products, in which case taking a reorder of toothpaste or toothbrush or something like that would be easier for one customer than another. Again, it's important that you know your clients. She can order daily use products. No need to shop for them. And you'll find that our prices for daily use products are competitive with grocery store prices. In one visit with you, she receives her current order and she can provide for future needs. She saves money by taking advantage of current special prices. Again, some women are very savvy and will wait for those specials. She's interested in new products, new ideas, new try-ons. And you'll find that a subset of your customers love new things. They love to experiment. They love to try on. And that subset of customers will be very interested in what you have to show them each visit and may be very open to reorders when you deliver an order. So dependable service means reorders. Something they can count on. And reorders depend on you. It's up to you to show and sell. Point out specials. Suggest things. And ask for the order. So you'll see your first two steps. Call on every home and suggest a reorder on every delivery call. Your first two steps. And the next time I see you, we'll discuss new customers for a growing business. And that will be our third and final step. And so I'll be here next week when you're ready to submit your order, and we can talk about any questions that you might have, and then we'll go over that third brochure. Finally, things I need to drop off. As I mentioned, forgot these last time, but here is your purchase order. So you can go ahead and start tallying if you like. You just need to look in your order forms. At this point, you should still have two copies for each customer, and your customer received the tissue paper copy when you left. Is that correct? Okay. And there are two copies of the purchase order. And you just need to buy some carbon. Makes it much easier, but you can fill it out however you like if you would like to fill them out separately. But I did, I like to buy this, these carbon sets. Executives tend to use them. You just tear that off. And it keeps the carbon protected. Of course, this is the piece of paper that this will keep on file, and then they'll put their letterhead on top here and type. But the reason I like these again is because I don't work in an office. I don't like getting carbon all over my hands. And you can see it's protected. And so this is what I do. One. Put it under the carbon. Make sure it's even. And then I put one on top. And I always have this little clip. Handy. That I make is going to come through on the second copy. And I went over how to fill out the bottom part of the form. So I will expect that this form is completely filled out when we meet next week, and that way I can do a quick review and make sure that everything is in order before you submit your very first order. You will submit the top copy. All you need to do is fold it, put it in an envelope, send it off to Avon. And this time again, you will not be including a check for your previous order, since this one is your first. Then you'll keep the other copy for your records. And I just like to use a folder like this to keep lots of my Avon records in. And let's see, is that it? leave this with you. This is my copy. If you would like one, you can order it in your first order right up here. But I'd like for you to get a good sense of what's in it, and that way you can decide whether you want to purchase it. Your guide to the basic facts of beauty. Now, what I tell all new Avon representatives is it's much easier to work with fragrance at first and skincare, and to allow yourself to have some time to get to know each one of your customers and things that they are interested in, at the same time that you are educating yourself about beauty. It's important that your clients trust you, and you want to be able to present them with some degree of expertise. This book is really crucial in learning all about not just Avon products specifically, but beauty in general. I'll leave this with you for the next week, and I'll pick it up next week, okay? And then if you like what you see inside, then just order it on your first order. And two other things that I'm going to loan you are our cream supreme. Has a very distinct fragrance that's not too overpowering. It will smell very nice as your customers put it on, but that fragrance will fade quickly, and that's by design, because this is not a fragrance product. We don't want that scent to mix with fragrance products that they may be wearing. The same is true of the Vitamoist. And I always like to have these two in my beauty showcase. Oh, it smells so good. If I know I'm going to be calling on new clients or clients that have never tried these before. Now, if I know that I'm going to be seeing 6 or 7 customers today, and they all have one or the other of these, or we've talked about it in the past, again, your notebook, it's very important, then I won't bring these along, because they are of heavy. But the short version, Cream Supreme for dry skin, Vitamoist for normal or oily skin. And Cream Supreme is also very good for mature skin. Okay. So I'll let you take these with you in the next week as you make your calls to the remainder of your territory, or as much as you can get through. You're not going to get through the entire territory in 2 weeks. I can tell you that. But anyway. And then please keep a note of what you've demonstrated, so you'll know that the customers you've already taken orders from have not had a chance to see these and try them. To keep those things straight. All right. Well, I'll leave you to it. certainly don't have as much to carry in. Or excuse me, to carry home as I carried in. Don't hesitate to call me if you have any questions about anything. Alright, Charlene, good luck in your second week. Have fun with your beauty showcase. And we'll get your order ready for next week, okay?